Hello everyone, my name is Chad Smith, and today I'm going to be continuing our Simplicity Alarming series by talking about alarm setups. In a system where there are a lot of alarms, an operator can often get overwhelmed by too many alarms demanding attention at once. Alarm setups allow operators to apply filters to their alarming view so that they can more easily identify the most critical and important issues. For example, in this scenario, you can see that we have a filter button below to show only the alarms that have to do with temperatures in the system. So by filtering that, we have a smaller view specifically related to what alarms I want to see at this moment in time. To do this in Simplicity, we use the alarm setup section in the workbench, where you can see you are able to add any number of different alarm saved setups, which essentially are filters. And so, for example, in the case I just showed, we have a temperatures setup where we have decided to filter by just the temperatures resource. So in our point database, we can see that our temperature has a resource of temperatures. So all of the temperature variables in the database have this resource ID. When we go to our alarm setups, the temperatures setup will only show points that have the temperatures resource as their resource. Setups also allow you to filter by the alarm class that you specify on an alarm. So for this example, let's set up a new filter alarm setup that will only show points who are in class demo 2. So let's create a new filter called by class. And setups are configured on a per user basis. So only those filters created for admin can be seen by admin. If I'm logged in as something other than admin, I won't see the admin filters, but I can create filters for particular users. So if I create a new setup that I only want to show alarms that are of type demo 2, and everything else will leave the same. And then if I go into my points and I change one of my points classes to be demo 2, then I should only see the temperature variable alarm when I select that particular filter. So there's a couple of ways to interact with the setups. I'm going to show you one now and a couple later as well. So in this case, I'm going to show you the properties for this alarm control. And if I'd like to directly interact with setups from my alarm viewer, I can actually add the setup button to the alarm viewer. And when I hit that setup button, I'm given my list of alarm setups to choose from. And in this case, we'll choose by class. And you can see that when I chose that, only the temperature alarm that we set the demo 2 class to shows up in the alarm viewer because of that filter. I can also interact with the setups via the API. I'll just quickly show you how that is done briefly. So if I go to the SimEdit screen and show you that button, or show you the temperature button, in the events on a mouse down, I can set up an action as a procedure, and I can actually invoke a method on the alarm viewer and choose the set project setup. And then in the set, in the advanced properties, I can say, the actual setup name and which project it comes from. So that's pretty flexible. And finally, I'll just point out the couple of other parameters that are available In the setup scenario, you can also filter by time. So if I enable this here, I can get all the alarms since a certain timestamp, and I can filter by state. And all of that's described really well here in the help, what filter by state is and filter by time is. Thanks for watching.